Let's take up bonding in complex compound or coordination compounds. First, we are taking valence bond theory. According to this theory, the metal atom or ion under the influence of ligands can use N-1D, NSNP or NSNPNT orbitals for hybridization. When it uses N-1D and NSNP orbital, we call it inner orbital complex. When it uses NSNP and ND orbitals, we call it outer orbital complex. It leads to the formation of equivalent set of orbitals with a definite geometry such as octahedral, tetrahedral, square planar and so on. These hybridized orbitals are allowed to overlap with the ligand orbitals that can donate a pair of electrons or lone pair of electrons for coordinate bond formation. If coordination number is 4, hybridization can be sp3 shape will be tetrahedral. If coordination number is 4 and hybridization is dsp2, shape will be square planar. If coordination number is 5, sp3d hybridization or dsp3 hybridization, it will be trigonal bipyramidal. With coordination number 6, sp3d2 or d2sp3, shape will be octahedral. And if there is coordination of hybridization will be sp3, shape will be linear. Let's take up orbitals of cobalt plus 3 ions. Here we have cobalt is 27, 4s2, 3d7. Two electrons from 4s orbital will be removed, one electron from 3d orbital will be removed, so we will get 3d6 left. And this is the situation of the 3d orbital in cobalt plus 3 ions. Now if we have strong field ligand like ammonia, so the pairing of electron will take place in the d orbital and we will be left with 2d orbitals which can be used for hybridization, and this will lead to inner orbital complex or low spin complex. It is usually possible to predict the geometry of complex from the knowledge of its magnetic behavior on the basis of valence bond theory. Let's take up magnetic properties of coordination compounds. The magnetic moment of the coordination compounds can be measured by the magnetic susceptibility experiments. The results can be used to obtain information about the structure adopted by metal complexes. The spin-only magnetic moment of MnBr42- is 5.9 bm Bohr magnetron. Predict the geometry of the complex ions. Now here Mn is 25, 4s2, 3d5. Mn plus 2 will be 3d5. Now there will be 5 unpaired electrons, so the magnetic moment will be 5 into 7 square root, 35 square root 5.9 bm. It means in this complex there are 5 unpaired electrons. So hybridization will be sp3 and it will be tetrahedral complex. Limitation of valence bond theory. While VB theory to a large extent explains the formation, structure and magnetic behavior of coordination complexes, it suffers from the following shortcomings. It involves a number of assumptions. It does not give quantitative interpretation of magnetic data. It does not explain the color exhibited by coordination compounds. It does not give a quantitative interpretation of thermodynamic or kinetic stability of coordination compounds. It does not make exact prediction regarding the tetrahedral and square planar structure with coordination number 4. And it does not distinguish clearly between weak field and strong field ligand. Crystal field theory. The crystal field theory denoted by CFT is an electrostatic model which considers metal ligand bond to be anionic, arising purely from the electrostatic interactions between metal ions and ligands. Ligands are treated as point charges in the case of anions and dipoles in the case of neutral molecule. All neutral molecules which act as ligand are polar in nature, so they have dipoles. And the negative end of the dipole will form coordinate bond, which are lone pair of electrons. The 5d orbitals in an isolated gaseous metal atom or ion have same energy, that is, they have degenerate d orbitals. The degeneracy is maintained if a spherically symmetrical field of negative charge ions surround the metal atom or ion. However, when this negative field is due to ligands, either anions or negative ends of the dipolar molecules like ammonia and water in a complex, it becomes asymmetrical and the degeneracy or equal energy of d orbital is removed and it results in splitting of d orbitals. The pattern of splitting depends upon the nature of crystal field. Let's explain this splitting in different crystal fields. Crystal field splitting in the octahedral coordination entities. The degeneracy of the d orbitals has been removed due to ligand electron metal electron repulsion in the octahedral complexes to yield three orbitals of lower energy T2g orbitals and two orbitals of higher energy which is called Eg set. This is the way how splitting takes place. In octahedral complexes, first we have 5d orbitals, dxy, dyz and dzx. These are 3d orbitals and 2d orbitals we have dx square minus y square and dz square. These two orbitals dx square minus y square and dz squares are on the axis, whereas dxy, dyz and dzx are on in between the axis. So in octahedral complexes, all the ligands will approach on the axis. So the d orbital which are on the axis will be repelled more and their energy will increase and they will form Eg set of orbitals. And dxy, dyz and dzx or xz which are between the axes will be repelled less and they will be in the lower state, that is forming T2g orbitals. So this splitting of d orbitals in two sets of orbitals is called crystal field splitting. These are in original state and these are in spherical field and these are in octahedral field. So this splitting we have shown in octahedral field. The splitting of the degenerate levels due to presence of ligands in geometry, in definite geometry, is termed as crystal field splitting. The energy of separation between the d orbitals, here we have shown the energy of separation, this total energy of separation is denoted by delta zero and or delta O, octahedral crystal field splitting energy, is termed as energy of separation is called crystal field splitting energy. O stands for octahedral, T stands for tetrahedral, and here it is octahedral crystal field splitting energy denoted by delta zero or delta O. The energy of the two Eg orbitals will increase by 3 by 5 of delta O and that of 3 T2g will decrease by 2 by 5 delta O. The crystal field splitting delta O depends upon the field produced by ligand and the charge on the central metal ion. The stronger the ligand, more will be crystal field splitting energy. And higher the charge and smaller the cation, more will be crystal field splitting energy. Ligands can be arranged in the series in the order of increasing field strength as given below, and this is called spectrochemical series. Iodide ion is the weakest ligand, then bromide, thiocyanate ion, chloride, sulfide, fluoride, hydroxide, oxalate, water, isothiocyanate, EDTA 4-, ammonia, EN, cyanide. Carbon monoxide is the strongest ligand. It can form sigma bond as well as pi bond in metal carbon ion. Such a series is termed as spectrochemical series. For D4 ions, two possible pattern of electron distribution arises, which we are going to discuss. Which of these possibilities occur depend upon the relative magnitude of the crystal field splitting energy delta O and the energy required for pairing of electrons. P represents the energy required for electron pairing in a single orbital. If octahedral splitting energy is less than energy required for pairing, so the fourth electron enters one of the Eg orbitals. Because pairing energy is more, so the it will take place in T2g and Eg1. Pairing energy is more means the fourth electron is going to Eg orbital. If pairing energy is less, then pairing will start in this T2g orbitals. So its electronic configuration will be T2G3 and Eg1. Ligands for which delta O is less than P are called, known as weak field ligands, and they will form high spin complex because large number of unpaired electrons will be present. If delta O is greater than P, that is, it becomes more energetically favorable for the fourth electron to enter the T2G orbital. With the configuration T2G4 and Eg will be zero. These ligands which produce this effect are known as strong field ligand and form low spin complex because there are no unpaired electrons or minimum number of unpaired electrons. Calculations show that D4 to D7 coordination entities are more stable for strong field as compared to weak field cases. Crystal field spreading in tetrahedral coordination entities. In tetrahedral coordination entity formation, the d orbital splitting is inverted and is smaller as compared to the octahedral crystal field splitting. The same metal, same ligands and metal ligand distances, it can be shown that tetrahedral splitting is 4/9 of the octahedral splitting energy. This diagram shows tetrahedral splitting. Here we have degenerate d orbitals in isolated gaseous atom or ions, and here we have got in spherical fields, and this is the splitting in tetrahedral field. Here this is inverted, here we have 3/5 delta t, and here we have 2/5 delta t. Now tetrahedral in field, the ligand has to occupy the position in between the axes. So the d orbitals which are on the axis will not feel repulsion and they will have lower energy. Dxy, dyz, these zx orbitals which are in between the axes, they will feel more repulsion from the ligands and they will have higher energy. That is the reason that the splitting is inverted. Here we have Eg orbital which are 2 and here we have T2G orbital which are 3. So this diagram shows crystal field splitting in tetrahedral complexes, and this is the total energy of separation between the d orbital, which is called crystal field splitting energy denoted by delta t. Relationship between the wavelength of light absorbed and the color observed in some coordination entities are given. This is a complex compound. It absorbs 535 nanometer, that is yellow color is absorbed, violet color is radiated, so violet color is complementary to yellow color. The next complex, 500 nanometer, it is absorbing blue-green color, it absorbs, and red color, it radiates. The third complex absorbs 475 nanometer, blue color, it absorbs, yellow color, it radiates. The next complex absorbs 310 nanometer ultraviolet light and radiates pale yellow color. And this tetra aqua copper 2 ion complex absorbs 600 nanometer, that is red color, and it radiates blue color. Titanium with the 6 water molecules, 3 positive charge, absorbs 498 nanometer. It absorbs blue color, green color, and appears purple. The color in the coordination compounds can be readily explained in the terms of crystal field theory. The crystal field theory attributes the color of coordination compounds to d-d transition of the electrons. d-d transition means that from T2G and Eg orbitals, the electron can jump by absorbing light from visible region and radiate complementary color. These are called d-d transitions. Limitations of crystal field theory. The crystal field model is successful in explaining the formation, structure, color, and magnetic properties of the coordination compounds to a large extent. However, from the assumption that the ligands are point charges, it follows that anionic ligands should exert the greatest splitting effect. The anionic ligands actual are found to be at the low end of spectrochemical series, whereas neutral ligand like carbon monoxide or carbonyl group has got is the strongest field ligand. So this does not hold good, that anionic ligands exert greater splitting effect. So this assumption is not very correct, that ligands are point charges. It does not take into account the covalent character of bonding between the ligand and the central atom.